Aquarius. Welcome to Carol's Universe Tarot Readings from the Heart. Thanks ever so much for joining me on your year ahead 2017 reading. I'm doing this in the form of the live spread. For some of you guys who have been with me a long time, you'll know that there were two live spreads done last year, 6 months apart, sort of half yearly ones. Well, this year I'm just going to be doing the one, and this will be the only one live spread that you'll get for the year ahead. And it's just focusing completely on 2017, what could be coming in for Aquarius, Sun, Moon and Rising signs. For those of you who don't know the live spread focuses on five areas of your life. So it will focus on your personal situation, your career, your home life, your love life, and also the running theme through the year, stroke future events, okay? Usually I find the future events, which are usually here. Usually it's the sort of the energies that are running, sort of trickling through everything during the year. So it can be sort of a future event towards the end of the year or something that's trickling through the year. And also your advice card. Now I'm using the Radiant Rider-Waite deck. It's the same as the Rider-Waite, it's just on glossier card. I'm also using, we use a second deck, the Witch's Tarot. I use the Witch's Tarot for the second deck. Out of this deck, we use all of the majors. We're using the majors, so we've got 21 major cards here, but we only use 7 out of that. And what those 7 cards do is they provide an anchor. So out of all of the 5 areas, you'll have 5 of those 7 cards that will show you the outcome of each area. Okay, so where everything is heading. So your love life, card number 3 is the overall outcome in the anchor, where the love life might be heading for some of you guys. Card number 1 will be the present situation, where everything's heading in terms of present situation, but that card also doubles as the focus for the year. So what you'll probably be concentrating on, the foundation of your lives during that year, 2017. And, you know, you've got your overall outcome for your careers, running theme, stroke, future, home life. And then the final 2 cards, card number 5 and 7. Card number 5 is where you guys should be wishing everything will head in 2017 pertaining to this life spread. And the overall card is number 7, which is the overall outcome for all the areas, or pretty much all of the areas. So let's make a start, Aquarius. We're just going to focus on the word Aquarius. Universe, Spirit, show me Aquarius in 2017. What could be coming in for Aquarius, Sun, Moon and Rising signs? Aquarius, Sun, Moon and Rising signs. Aquarius, Sun, Moon and Rising signs for the year 2017. Show me what could be coming in for Aquarius, Sun, Moon and Rising signs. Aquarius, Sun, Moon and Rising signs. Aquarius, Sun, Moon and Rising signs for the year 2017. Show me their personal situations, career, home life for Aquarius, Sun, Moon and Rising signs, love life, and also the running theme through the year stroke, future events, and the advice card for Aquarius, Sun, Moon and Rising signs, show me. All right, so we've shuffled the cards, and what we're going to do, we're going to split that deck into 3. We're going to collect it back up, and what we'll do is we'll deal that out in a moment. We're going to shuffle now for the anchor cards. Universe, Spirit, show me the foundation of Aquarius, Sun, Moon and Rising signs and the stroke focus for their lives in 2017 in card number 1. Also, this card should show the overall outcome for the personal situation. Show me the overall situation for their careers, for their love lives, overall situation in terms of their home lives, and also the running theme stroke future card. And also show me where they are wishing for everything to head in 2017 pertaining to their life spread, and also the overall outcome of where everything should be heading for them in 2017. Show me. We're going to split the deck into 3 on this one as well. Collect it back up and we'll deal that out afterwards. Right, so first things first, let's lay down. So we start with the personal situation. The live spread is made up of groups of 4. So the top card shows the general energy some of you guys may be facing in the year 2017. This is your personal situation. It's the same for all the areas. And the last 3 cards in this group should show the situations around this energy here, and it can also be giving you a message as well as how things are going to go. We're going to deal out for your career here, Aquarius. your home lives, your love lives, and also the running theme through the year stroke future events. And this card is the advice card. Okay, so that's the first lot done. And then now we're going to deal the foundation, stroke focus for the year, stroke overall outcome for the personal situation, your careers, overall outcome for the career, outcome for love, outcome for home, what you're potentially wishing will happen, or wishing what direction you're wishing everything will go in terms of the life spread, overall outcome for the running theme stroke future events, and the overall outcome where everything should be heading in 2017. Right, let me just get a... I'm wondering if I've got a pen here that I can use as a point. I call them pointers because I like to point towards the cards. We'll use this one here. All right, pardon me as well if I tend to drink my green juice. It gives me energy because these take a long time to do. Okay, so let's have a look. We will start with the focus for the year, stroke foundation. Well, the Hanged Man shows up as potentially the focus for the year. And when you get the Hanged Man means many, many things, as all of the cards practically do within the tarot. There's never one card that sticks with one thing. I mean, you know, you do get certain cards, Nine of Swords, Five of Cups, you know, that can say that you're feeling, you know, Nine of Swords, I'm a little bit worried, or I'm quite worried, or I'm, you know, I can't stop thinking about something, I'm agitated, I'm anxious. Five of Cups, I'm feeling sad about something. Sometimes Five of Cups is not that serious. You know, you could lose something and you're missing it or something like that. But those types of cards, the general ethos is sadness or anxiety. But cards like the Hanged Man, this can mean that for some of you guys, I mean, the focus for the year might be on limitations within your life, because the Hanged Man is a card about limitations. It's a card that shows up when your hands are tied, where there is something that's being held up, or there's an obstacle there, or... there is a difficulty, or there's some form of a struggle that you can't kind of wriggle your way out of, or that there's an obstacle in a certain situation that suddenly kind of comes in your way, or something needs to be put on hold. It doesn't always mean death with the Hanged Man or something's ending. It usually means that this thing is in the suspense. It usually means that, you know, there's something that cannot kind of move at the moment. It's one of those cards that shows sometimes that there is non-movement. Sometimes this can mean that you're holding on to something. Some of you guys will be holding on to something in 2017. Some of you guys might feel that your hands are tied. But the other side of the Hanged Man is where we are needing to look at situations in a completely different way, because that's the only way that you can look at it. So some of you guys, the focus foundation for your lives in 2017, Taurus, might be that you're adjusting the way that you see the world, or you see a particular situation, because tied in with that is the idea of surrender and the idea of letting go and letting God. So for some people, they're holding on to things, but after a certain amount of time, the longer that you hold on to something, Aquarius, the less likely it is to move. So sometimes all you can do is let go and let God, just surrender to whatever that is. And some of you guys will be learning to let go. You will be learning to give up the ghost. You will be learning to stop holding on to situations that possibly with this Hanged Man you can't really do much about. This card can also mean that you make sacrifices as well. This guy is sacrificing his comfort in the pursuit of gaining some form of spiritual or more in-depth knowledge. So sometimes this is the card of endurance and having to sacrifice our own comfort or our own way of doing things or our own patterns in order to try and learn more about who we are or who other people are. So this can be where you're sacrificing or making some form of a sacrifice in 2017, Aquarius, in order to gain far more power. The Hanged Man does strengthen you. It really is a card of strength because it represents enduring discomfort in the pursuit of happiness in the long term. So sometimes this card for me is about enduring long-term situations, because after you've endured, what comes about afterwards is the happiness and the hope that you would have gained in the eventual course of a situation. The Hanged Man for me is a card about, as I've said, surrendering and letting go and letting God. And if you can surrender in 2017 to less than desirable situations, then it really, this is the card that says after a time of difficulty or an unstable or a difficult situation that maybe your hands are tied on, in the long run, it's the best thing because it strengthens you and it gives you more power as an individual. And in the end, it gives you more control, especially off your own self. So I feel that some of you guys, 2017, there will be situations you're going to have to endure because there might be things that you can't do about it. Some of you guys will be adjusting your perception on a situation, on life, on others potentially. Some of you guys might be making certain sacrifices, and some of you guys also, you know, might find yourselves with your hands tied and there's not a lot that you can do about it. But it's all in the aid of kind of just acceptance. The Hanged Man for me is also a card of self-acceptance. So for some of you guys, the focus for the year 2017 might be on self-acceptance, no matter how difficult that might be. This guy here, it's very difficult to hang upside down on a tree, but he's got a halo above his head, if you can see. So there's a certain sense of martyrdom to this as well. He's sacrificing his comfort for the greater good, and that's what some of you guys might actually be doing in 2017. Let's go to your personal situation, Aquarius, and have a look at what the general energy is around your personal situation here. While the Chariot, there could be something to do with travel, possibly even vehicles. Chariot does represent the car, after all. So sometimes when you get this, I'm not going to give you anything as mundane as you might be buying a car. You might be buying a car. You might be looking at a special car to buy with this Chariot card. Because often when you get this in a reading, it can be something to do with car trouble. But usually I find that that's when that it's in the reverse, or if it's badly aspected by stuff. Some of you guys might be looking at travel here, or you might be looking at purchasing a vehicle, that type of thing in 2017 in your personal situation. It can also mean that some of you guys will have to take greater control, I feel, of the family situations. The Chariot often represents the house of home and family, astrologically wise, zodiac wise. So this can be where you're having to take control of a family situation, perhaps kind of keep people in line, children in line, steering them towards the correct path. For some of you guys, it might be, Aquarius, that you are caught between a rock and a hard place, or there are decisions that you have to make, because the Chariot can be a card about decisions that need to be made, because this person is pulled in two directions by this Sphinx here and by this Sphinx here. Really, it's which way do I go? We don't really want to add that black is negative and white is not negative, but you know, it can be, do I go in this direction, or do I go in that direction? So some of you guys, you're going to need to, you know, there's going to be something about confidence and building your confidence through aligning certain situations, through your own sense of ambition, your own sense of power, your own sense of fortitude, your own sense of strength, because this is what the Charioteer here does. If we were to look at this in terms of an energy card, for me, this is a card that says, you know, the doubts are the Sphinxes here, and this guy has to align those doubts in order to move forward. So some of you guys might be very focused on within your personal situations in victory. You might be very focused on overcoming certain obstacles, and you're going to need to persevere, and you're going to need to be strong, and you're going to need to kind of be very, very confident about those things, because that's what the Chariot is. It's a card about having confidence, the confidence to overcome difficulties within your life. Let's have a look at the, this might be a Cancerian individual. If this is an individual within your personal situation, you're kind of a bit screwed, because this is a card just like the Knight of Wands. If it's anything to do with love, Chariot guy is no good really, because this person's just out for sex or just out for fun. So this isn't somebody that you can particularly rely on in a love relationship. Let's have a look though what comes underneath the Chariot. Well, we've got the Knight of Pentacles. So there might be some long-term goals that some of you guys are looking for. Sometimes this card can also show up when you're actually being rewarded or being presented with an award, or you're being presented with something. So some of you guys might be presented with something via the Knight of Pentacles. The Knight of Pentacles can be somebody, Virgo, Capricorn, Taurus. Usually I think this might be a Virgo individual who comes into your life. But this can also be that you could be considering travel as well. The Knight of Pentacles often references somebody who travels. So we've got two travel cards here. The Chariot might be some traveling that you're doing in 2017. And we do have the Knight of Pentacles here, Aquarius. Alternatively, as I've said, this could also be a card that speaks of long-term desires, long-term goals. But this is the card of strategy. And it's not, you know, you get its counterparts, its brothers, you know, Knight of Swords, Knight of Wands, Knight of Swords, Knight of Wands, they're go-getters. They will just go, 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 go. And sometimes they don't think. They go with their passions, or, you know, they'll just go with a thought, and the thought feels good to them, so they'll just go for something. The Knight of Pentacles, which is why I feel that this is the most successful knight of the lot, really doesn't kind of rush into things. He takes his time. He's called the Duddering Knight, or the Dull Knight within the tarot, because he moves so slowly. But he only moves slowly because he has a plan of action. So some of you guys might have a plan of action with this Knight of Pentacles. Some of you guys in your personal situation might be quite stable financially, or your plan of action is to be financially stable here with this card. But you're moving slowly and cautiously, and you have an action plan that you're actually developing with this card when it shows up. Let's have a look at the other cards. Well, we've got another money card here. So I feel that it is a slow move towards success with that Nine of Pentacles. Some of you guys might be presented with a new home, because the Knight of Pentacles can be a presentation, and the Nine of Pentacles can be a new home, a really nice home. So if you find that you are living in 2016 in a less than desirable apartment or home, it could be with that Knight of Pentacles that you're being presented, if we're looking at keywords, with the Nine of Pentacles, a nicer home. For some of you guys, it might be a home. For some of you guys, it might be you're being presented maybe with a new job. Maybe a job, a home comes along with a job, because this is the card of, after all, about working from home or developing your own business. But this card really shows rewards for effort. So you might be receiving a reward for all the effort that you've put in here with the Nine of Pentacles energy. Okay, this could also be perhaps a new job that's being presented to you. Or it could be that what you're presented with is, with this Nine of Pentacles, it shows great wealth. So it could be that something that you're presented with is providing you with great wealth, great abundance. Nine of Pentacles is one of the best cards to get in terms of money, because it shows a lot of money. Not so much a lot of money, but it shows that you're going to be comfortable. Some of you guys will be working hard towards security and stability with that Nine of Pentacles as well. What's showing up with that? Well, the two, we've got all money cards here. That's incredible. Now, the Two of Pentacles is the card. It's an interesting card because it represents having to weigh things up. But it also represents, you know, you've got the sea behind this individual, which says that this person might be juggling with many things. Okay. It could be for some of you guys that maybe somebody is coming in, especially if you're a single person. Maybe here you're single, and maybe here you find yourself juggling a relationship, okay? Because the Knight of Pentacles seems to be presenting something towards a single individual. And it could be as a result of that, with that Two of Pentacles, that you're actually juggling two relationships, or you're juggling, you know, a relationship with someone, but you're also juggling a job. You can see on this card here with the Two of Pentacles, there is the sea that is up and down, which represents that this person's feeling a little bit jaded. They're trying to make things work, but it's kind of getting to them a little bit emotionally wise. Their emotions might be a little bit up and down. Okay, so, you know, it suggests that you're trying to cope with a couple of things at once. So you might be trying to cope with, you know, many projects or many things. Okay, this could be something around the home, though, for sure. And they're all pentacle cards. All right, so it might be that you're being presented with a project, for example, with that Knight of Pentacles. The Knight of Pentacles presents something to the Nine of Pentacles, and it means that with the Two of Pentacles, you're juggling more than one thing. So it could be an increase in projects as well in your personal situation, even, in terms of work. Some of you guys with this Nine of Pentacles might actually be working for yourself, okay? And with this Knight of Pentacles presenting this pentacle to this person on the Nine of Pentacles, it just really adds to what they already have to do, or what they're already dealing with. So it might be that there is an increase here with the work that you have in 2017, Aquarius, with these cards. They're all money cards, which leads me to think that this is kind of something to do with the material world, money, because they're all financial cards, every single one of them here. The Chariot could be as the general energy in the present in your personal situations, that you are actually achieving something of magnitude, because the Chariot is about making some form of achievement. Could be that you're overcoming obstacles as well with this card. But it could also be that if you work from home with that Nine of Pentacles, maybe somebody's presenting you with an opportunity. Man presents opportunity to person that runs their own business. And this person here may be undecided with the Two of Pentacles. as to what do I do? Do I carry on working from home or do I take this here? Which is why the Chariot as the overall energy might mean that you're kind of being pulled in two directions, perhaps over a decision that you need to make, because both the Chariot and that Two of Pentacles can also be cards that references decisions that one needs to make. So if you guys, you're juggling money here, it might be that you're a single parent and you're juggling many things, children, and also this is the card of house and home. So for some of you guys, Aquarius, it might be that the overall energy for your personal situation is trying to take control, because the Chariot references the one of the words, keywords we can look at with the Chariot is trying to take control. Some of you guys might be trying to take control of your working life and your home life. And underneath that, we see that somebody is presenting you. You're being offered something from the Knight of Pentacles, possibly towards what you're already doing. So Knight of Pentacles could be offering independent individual more projects with the Two of Pentacles, because the Two of Pentacles reference is not just to handle one thing, but to handle many things at once. So it could be Knight of Pentacles is presenting independent person or single parent. Usually the number nine, the Nine of Pentacles, can reference somebody who's single or a single parent, that type of thing. Knight of Pentacles is presenting single parent with a couple of options. So it could be that you're being presented by the Knight of Pentacles. You are being presented by the Knight of Pentacles with a couple of options. Some of you guys might have a couple of options. When you get a lot of pentacles also within a reading, it can simply mean that situations are starting to actually take form. Because remember, the pentacles are the outcomes within the tarot, okay? So they're the table that I work on. They're the money that I earn, okay? They're the cameras that I work off. They're the money that sits in my bank account. They're the, you know, they are the, what's the word? They are the leverage that I use to kind of, you know, maneuver my way through the world, if you like. So it's not always money, pentacles. It is a lot of the time, though, especially when you get a Nine of Pentacles. I feel that some of you guys are stable here with this card, but I feel that you're being presented something. If you look at tarot interaction, a good way to do tarot is to look at how the cards are interacting with each other, the pictures, which is why I like using the Rider-Waite, because I think that they are the very best cards to use when you're looking at an interaction between cards. So man is presenting offer to an independent person, or man is presenting options, Two of Pentacles, to an independent person, or man is presenting an option to an independent person, and you'll need to weigh it up with the Two of Pentacles, that you need to weigh it with the Two of Pentacles, because it could mean that you're taking on more than you can actually cope with. This person has a lot of pentacles around them. It's not just what they've built up here, but they're managing a whole thing. This Nine of Pentacles says to me that somebody's managing many things, not just pentacles, but it's the grapes, it's the leaves. This person works in falconry, so they've trained in something, okay? So it might be that somebody offers you a training position, Nine of Pentacles, and you'll need to weigh this up. Or it could be a person offers training situation, or an opportunity to train in a certain area with that Nine of Pentacles that you'll need to consider. And why will you need to consider it? Because the overall energy is the Chariot, and it might be that you are handling many things at the one time with these cards, and that's why potentially the overall outcome in terms of your personal situation is the Hanged Man. Maybe your hands are tied, because we do have this card where it shows somebody who's weighing something up. It's not always money that somebody weighs up. Sometimes they're trying to, you know, they're trying to look at something in one way and then looking at it in the other. Sometimes this card can mean, well, I'm trying to see both sides of the story, or I'm trying to kind of balance out the way that things work. You know, I'm trying to see things from one point of view and I'm trying to see things from the other. This is what this card can also mean. And the Hanged Man is the same thing. I'm trying to look at this thing from a different perspective, but I just need a little bit of time to kind of get my bearings on it. So this is sometimes a pause and reflect. So some of you guys in your personal situation, I feel that you are being offered something, because you've got a Knight of Pentacles facing you. Even though you're not an Earth sign, it doesn't matter. You don't need to be an Earth sign with the Nine of Pentacles. You can just say that you've got possibly a lot on your plate, or possibly you are independent as an individual here, and that this offer we can see with the Knight of Pentacles being offered to an independent person, possibly even a single parent, that type of thing, will need some form of careful consideration with the Two of Pentacles. You need to weigh it up, because that sea behind you says that, you know, you've got a lot going on. Situation is not that rosy. It's not that easy to kind of navigate or maneuver your way yourself through. And with that Chariot being the general energy, I feel that some of you guys might be pulled in two directions, and also the general energy as well. I have responsibility, because this person here on the Chariot is responsible for the two Sphinxes and keeping them in line. And this can easily be a parent here and a couple of children. So it might be, you know, these are the two children here on the Two of Pentacles. Well, what do I do with the kids? You know, if I take this opportunity, maybe even to increase my business, what do I do with the kids, picking them up, that type of thing. So I feel that there is consideration in terms of family and home affairs potentially here, but also potentially within a work situation too, which is why with that Hanged Man, it might be that some of you guys are considering taking on more. This is where usually where somebody's running one business, but this person here can be doing two things, possibly even running two businesses, coping with two businesses, or coping with more than one project. And this is something I feel the overall outcome with the Hanged Man, it's saying, you know what, I need to kind of take a bit of time out and think about what I want to do, or it might be while my hands are tied at the moment. I don't know whether I can do this. Let's have a look at your career, though. The personal situation can relate to a career, love, whatever it is that's important to you at the time. Let's have a look at career for 2017, potentially for Aquarius. I keep getting this card a lot for the signs in their careers, the Nine of Wands. Nine of Wands in terms of career can mean that you stand out. It can mean that because this person stands out, it can mean that you've got one idea because he's holding on to one wand. Okay, it can mean that you've had a lot of ideas that maybe haven't worked out, but the one idea you're sticking to, and you're willing to see that thing through to the bitter end because you really have a sense of belief with the Nine of Wands when that card shows up. For some of you guys, it might mean that you're persevering. For sometimes this card can mean that you have a test. Okay, you're going through a test, so it can be that you have, you know, a first interview or a second interview or something like that. It can mean that you're holding out for something as well in terms of career. What comes underneath this card? Well, it's brilliant because there should be, there could be something around groups as well, a team of people, because you've got the Three of Cups. Three of Cups can mean that you're collaborating quite happily with others in terms of something to do with teamwork in the year 2017, Aquarius, regarding your careers. It can also mean that there is something quite successful that you're celebrating, or you've had a successful outcome to something. So if you're waiting here for something, if you're going through it, the general energy is something to do with a test or, in, you know, interviews, that type of thing. It can be saying that one of the cards here is showing a celebration. Maybe you win, maybe you get the job or something, but we won't know until we see the other cards. Well, we've got another three of Pentacles. There's definitely something to do with, possibly you might be celebrating a promotion, because the Three of Pentacles in terms of work can represent promotions. You see this guy standing here. This person's being promoted because people are asking him for advice. So sometimes this card, pertaining to what you really get it with or around, can mean that you're the person who's actually asking for the work, or it can mean that you're actually being promoted. So some of you guys, because we've got the Three of Cups here, it could mean that there are celebrations around a promotion. Or it could mean that there are successful collaborations for some of you guys here. And what's the final card? Oh, wow. That's incredible. Ten of Cups. Very successful projects. So it could be that there is successful collaborations on a project with that Ten of Cups. Or successful collaboration on the completion of a project. Because if you think about the Three of Pentacles, this is where the best laid plans are being made. So this is a card that references somebody is developing something in terms of their career here. It can mean that you're celebrating a promotion. Possibly, Ten of Cups often means possibly leaving the job. Or you're starting something new. So it could be possibly celebrating promotion to a new job, maybe with that Ten of Cups. Or it could mean celebrating a promotion which leads to the ending of an era with that Ten of Cups, because tens usually represent the completion stage on something. Or it could be celebrating as a contract is completed, because the Three of Pentacles can often be, if you look at the piece of paper this person's holding here, could be a contract or something. So you might be celebrating the completion on a contract, or celebrating a contract being completed with that Ten of Cups. Because the energy is that you're waiting for something here. You've been through a test, or you've been through an interview, or you've stood out possibly to a recruiter or somebody who wants to order something from you, or somebody who wants to sanction some, is it sanction? I don't know whether the word is sanction, but they want to give the go-ahead to a project or something like that. That's why this card will sometimes turn up when you're working in the creative field, something like you're writing and you've, you know, you've put a manuscript in and somebody says, yeah, we really like that manuscript and we'd like to turn it into a film and that type of thing. There's definitely something successful within your careers that's happening here. You've got too many good cards for this not to be. So there's some very successful areas within your career, Aquarius, in the year 2017. Because the Three of Cups can be a successful collaboration, which results in a meeting. I don't know whether you could say with the Ten of Cups or that results in success with the Ten of Cups. So it could be collaboration, successful collaboration, or a successful... Three of Cups can be where you're meeting people, you see, as well. Where you're clanking glasses. There's an agreement here. So it could be agreement is successful. Or agreeing to a contract that is successful with the Ten of Cups. That brings happiness with the Ten of Cups, abundance, completion, or that completes your family or completes your life or something like that with the Ten of Cups. Ten of Cups is also about the biggest happiness that you can achieve. You know, you get Ten of Swords, the most pain, Ten of Pentacles, the most money, Ten of Wands, the most stress, while Ten of Cups is the most happiness. It could be, you know, whatever way you want to read those cards, there's success written all over it. Could be Three of Cups can often mean agreement as well. So agreement over a meeting, or agreement in a meeting, or agreement at a meeting brings the most happiness, Ten of Cups. So we can see, I feel that there's something that you guys are holding on, waiting out for here. You've either stood out to a recruiter, you know, somebody who wants to headhunt you in a job, or somebody is actually saying, you know, giving you the go-ahead on some form of a project here with this Nine of Wands. That's the energy. That there is something that you're waiting for, but it shows underneath this that there is celebration. Could be over a promotion that sees the end of an era, possibly moving jobs for some of you guys. It could be an agreement at a meeting. Possibly for some of you guys, home projects, that type of thing. But it could be successful meeting that results in the most happiness, Ten of Cups. There's definitely a lot of success. Some of you promotions, some of you certain projects will be given the go-ahead, be given the green light in the year 2017. What's the overall outcome in terms of your career? Well, the Empress, what an amazing card. I think you're the only sign that has had the Empress show up this year. I've not seen that Empress many times for many of the signs. This card is basically saying that you're going to have great wealth and abundance, because that's what the Empress is when you get it in an overall outcome. It says your dreams are being realised. It says that you're entering a stage of real growth. There is real growth in terms of your careers, Aquarius, that is coming to you in terms of your careers in 2017, because that's what the Empress is. The Empress is pregnant with ideas. She's a card that represents creativity and how you can earn money from a creative stage within your life. She's a card that represents somebody who has worked hard. She's toiled the earth, and look at what she's brought out from all of her hard work and effort. A very, very healthy harvest. So it says that you're going to have a very healthy harvest in terms of your work and careers. There should be money, there should be success, and there should be real comfort with this Empress. Very fertile time in terms of your career. Real great potential for growth with that Empress card showing there. That's really lovely. So far, so good. Really, really good. And it could align itself maybe with the personal situation. You know, so far, your cards are wonderful. I hope the love life is the same thing. I'm sick of giving shitty readings about love. I really hope it's, because it's so far so good with this reading. Exceptional reading so far. Exceptional reading. Okay. We'll join up some of these areas in a little while as well, because the life spread, you can join up areas. Areas might kind of sink into other areas. Let's have a look at what's going on in your home lives for some of you guys. Well, there's an individual showing a King of Pentacles, so this might be the main focus in terms of your home lives in the year 2017, Aquarius. And this could be a Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn. Usually the King of Pentacles is a Taurus individual, though. But for the purposes of the reading, as an earth sign, it could be, because it's a general reading, Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn individual. This is a very committed individual, because he's very... what can I say about the King of Pentacles? When we look at the King of Pentacles in terms of home life, this is not like getting a King of Wands. King of Wands can be a committed individual, but this can also be a philanderer. The King of Wands is often seen as a joker. He's a fire sign, so he's often very highly sexed as an individual. And also, the King of Wands is the type of person that will have a wife at home, but he'll go off and he'll have different women in different ports. The King of Pentacles is not like that. The King of Pentacles takes family life very, very seriously. Very, very seriously. He's very down to earth. But he's down to earth. He's very practical. So some of you guys might find yourself being quite practical. If this isn't a person in your life, it might be that you find yourselves kind of being very, very practical, being very on top of home matters. This is what the King of Pentacles is. Remember, kings do, queens be. So as a doer, the King of Pentacles knows everything about his financial state. He knows everything about when the bills need to be paid. He's got a direct debit set up. He's got, if for the American audience, I hope you know what a direct debit is. It's where money comes out of the bank. I'm sure you do, but I don't know. It's where money comes out of the bank every month. There's an agreement between you and the creditor, and they take money every month from your bank account. Direct debits, standing orders he's got set up, you know. He's on top of the bills, all right? So this person knows everything about their finances. And they make sure everything is paid out. This king is very ordered in terms of finances, home life. Everything's in its correct place. He lives in a very nice, clean home. He's a very clean individual. Okay, he takes responsibility. He's a very responsible individual, is the King of Pentacles. So if this isn't a person in your life, Aquarius, in your home life in 2017, then I feel that you guys will be taking great responsibility in terms of your home. Okay, your home lives, that's over your children, that's over your mothers, your fathers, you know, your wives, your husbands. You're going to be very, your bills, the food bill, the electricity, the gas, everything. You're really going to be putting things into some great order, and you'll be doing it. You will literally be doing it, all right, literally. The King of Pentacles means I look at the reality of my life in a very, very ordered fashion. All right, there is not one hair out of place when you get the King of Pentacles, because the King of Pentacles is a great perfectionist in terms of his home life. All right, he's got the best wife, or the best wife for him. He drives a nice car. He's got a great job. He's worked really hard to sustain a certain level within his home life. So you guys are going to be very focused, I feel. If this isn't an individual, you will be very, very focused, I feel, in terms of your home life, in terms of making maintaining some form of order. And that comes right from the top, right down to the bottom, right from the top of the chain, making sure that, you know, there's enough money in the bank, making sure that all your bills are paid, making sure that there's food on the table. And also the King of Pentacles does not overspend. As an individual, if he's a single guy, he can be the type of person who, you know, loves women, because he is ruled by Taurus, the bull, and that's a sign of wealth. So it might not just be wealth that you're looking at in terms of your home lives. It might be also the things that really matter to you. Sometimes if he's a single guy, he will be into fast cars, cigars, good food, steak, good wine, that type of thing. You know, the most beautiful women. He's a pretty superficial person, if single sort of thing. But in terms of home, very, very responsible. So I feel that you guys are looking to be really responsible, but not just in terms of material elements, but in terms of the things that really, really matter to you on a very kind of down-to-earth, in a very down-to-earth way. You can also say with this King of Pentacles, Aquarius, that this could be something to do with an estate agent, because the King of Pentacles can often show up as somebody who works in real estate, who might, you know, especially if you're trying to buy or, you know, sell a home, or you're trying to rent, this might be a very important individual in 2017. What is it about this individual? Well, the Page of Wands. Page of Wands can represent news or communication, okay? Sometimes this can be exciting communication that comes to you as well, because the pages are all about communication. They're communicative cards. Sometimes this card can mean a new adventure that's been taken, or you're taking a new path. So we've got the Page of Wands here, Aquarius. Sorry, if this video jumps, what happened was I recorded all of the video, an hour and 9 minutes of all of it. Thank you very much. This equipment, when I record, seems to be playing up. So I'm going to have to try and make this segment quite quick. It seems to play up after half an hour, whereas there is no sound. So I'm going to try it and see if I can record at half hour segments. 39 minutes is already done. So I'm continuing where I left off. I've had to turn the cards back around again. I know what's coming up now, which is a shame, because I like to kind of share in the excitement and the the surprise of what's coming up. Unfortunately, I already know, but there you go. This is for you and not for me anyway. You know, King of Pentacles could be a person around you in your home life. So with the life spread, everything can kind of interact with each other. We got a messenger card here, a Page of Wands, but also we've got, you know, so this could be positive communication with this Page of Wands showing here. It's concerning the general energy being a person, potentially a King of Pentacles. This can also be where there is a exciting development within a relationship. So you're starting out, you know, when pages come after aces, aces represent the conception. So you get an Ace of Wands, it's the start of passion. Or you're starting to feel excited. This can be the card with the page, because the page is the baby. And the if you were to think of it in pregnancy terms, the ace is where you, there is the conception, the seed and the egg meet. And, you know, the baby is start, you know. I'm not pregnant or anything, but you know, you've got that seed there, and it you know, it comes together in the womb, and this is where the baby's born. So this shows a development perhaps in a new relationship for some of you guys. What's it around the Page of Wands? Well, there we go, we got another child card, the Sun. These developments might look quite positive and optimistic with the Sun card, because the Sun card represents new relationships also, and things are exciting. And they are, you know, filled with the joys of spring, and there's a lot of happiness, and, you know, everything looks good when you get the Sun card. So I feel that there might be a relationship with the King of Pentacles here. It looks exciting. Now, even though this is home and it's not love, you can still get love in the home section here. What's the last card here? And wow, you've got the Wheel of Fortune. You've got some really good cards here. King of Pentacles could be a person around you. Potentially it's a new relationship. Looks really optimistic, with the potential for some real luck and great changes to be affecting your home life. King of Pentacles can also, as I've said, be a real estate agent. So, you know, be somebody who deals with property, and maybe the Page of Wands is something to do with, because wands often deal with moving and changes of location. It could be maybe there is a change of location here. Maybe you're moving to another country or something, because we've got the Sun, which can represent a hot country. The Page of Wands can represent a new adventure. Possibly new adventure, hot country, brings in big change maybe with that Wheel of Fortune here. Maybe this is the estate agent. So there's some really positive stuff. Could be love though with those cards, okay, around a particular person, because they're showing us the general energy in your home life for 2017. What's the outcome for home? Ah, the Moon. So the Moon card says, you know, when it's an overall outcome, you know, it's not... I mean, it could in a way be cautioning you, because if this is a relationship, to me, the vibe, the energy that I get from those cards is things are moving really fast and things look too good to be true in a way with those three cards showing here underneath this individual. Things look really good. Now, if I'd had a, you know, it's not to say the Moon is a bad card, but it can be that you're going to need to use your intuition on this one. You know, you look at this person here, Aquarius, and she's holding a torch. You know, she got a branch with fire on it. So she's using this to guide her way. This is the only light that she has. And when you get the Moon card, sometimes this is things look a certain way by the light of the Moon, or they look a certain way in the darkness. But in the light, they might look another way. So the overall outcome, I think, is saying that there's probably a lot more. If this is something to do with maybe moving to another country or something like that in terms of home life, Aquarius, it might be that there's still more that you need to find out with the Moon card, okay? Things look really good here, but the overall outcome isn't saying that this carries on being really, really good. It could do, It's not to say it won't, but it's saying almost, it's especially I feel that if it's love, just to be a little bit careful around that, because it could be with the moon card that potentially things are not as great as you feel that they are here, and that maybe there's still more enlightenment that you need around this situation, around this person. If there's somebody that comes into your home life and the energy is great around this person and everything seems to be going really well in terms of love, potentially the moon card is saying just be a little bit cautious here, because this woman, if I look at the card here, she's almost like she's a bit weary. And if I'm really looking at her face, I mean, if you really look at her face there, she's almost like, who's there? You know, who's there? Who is it? You know, she's questioning because she's a little bit fearful on this card. You know, she's on her guard. So I don't feel it's telling you to completely be on your guard, but I feel that it's almost saying, you know, look before you leap. Don't be so quick to jump into something within your home life here. It looks great. All the cards are amazing in this area, Aquarius. They really are quite beautiful. But the moon card is saying be a little bit cautious, because you don't, you know, this person here might be presenting something to you and everything looks amazing and it looks like it's going really, really well, whether it's a home move, whether it's you know, a new lover that comes into your life in the home life area. It does look amazing. The cards are all very, very good. It could be, you know, communication that leads, you know, communication is optimistic and brings in fortune or changes potentially within your home life here. It could be for some of you guys that this is, King of Pentacles can also represent great success. So the overall energy in terms of your home life with the King of Pentacles, not just a real estate agent or a potential lover, it can mean that you are, you know, you're taking responsibility in your home life for certain things here. And it might be with the Page of Wands that you're quite enthusiastic and optimistic with the Sun around some changes that you're bringing in terms of your home, whatever those changes might be. But it might say, you know, don't get too ahead of yourself in this area here, Aquarius, because you really need to do a little bit more homework, whether that's a new lover, whether that's a home move, whether that's home renovations, whatever it is that you're looking to do in 2017 around your home life. Just be aware that with the moon card, when this shows up, it's telling you to you not only to use your intuition. It can mean that, you know, it could mean potentially for love that with the moon card, maybe there is a psychic connection between you and this individual that's really kind of, you know, hitting the mark. You know, two people coming together and they're really starting to kind of influence each other's dreams. There's a really strong depth of feeling there when you get the moon card as well. But also this can be cautioning you and saying, you know, just be aware that things might look great now by the light of the moon, especially if it's love. You're whispering sweet nothings in each other's ear, but in the overall outcome, you know, there's still more that you need to kind of find out about this individual, because this is the negative copy of the Sun. This is where things look great as an outline, but we'd have to see the clearer picture, i.e. the Sun card, to know exactly whether it is something that we really want to invest our time into. What's going on in your love lives? Well, wow, the Four of Wands. I feel that this could be either family related, or it could mean that you're just having the greatest time in 2017, because the Four of Wands is about joy. It can mean also that you have initial success within a relationship. It can mean engagements, marriages, wedding parties, christenings, that type of thing. But we're talking about love here, love between two people. It looks like you're having a good time. Four of Wands can mean I'm having a good time. I'm socializing. I'm meeting different people. You know, I'm forming different relationships, that type of thing. What is it about the Four of Wands? Well, the Eight of Wands. So the Eight of Wands says that, you know, it might be, the Eight of Wands when it comes to love can mean that there, you know, you've got a lot of activity, lots of activity going on here, because it is a very active card. You're being very proactive, you're being very busy. It can also mean there's lots of communication coming your way, or you're sending lots of communication out there with that Eight of Wands. It can also mean, because the Eight of Wands to me is a law of attraction card, that maybe you're attracting in a lot of energy, or you're sending out a lot of energy. It's a very fast-paced card when you get the Eight of Wands. Lots of things going on. What have we got here? The Knight of Wands, and let's pull the other card. Right, the King of Cups. So I feel here there are two people around you in 2017 for some of you Aquarians, okay? One could be a fire sign, one could be a water sign. Now, the fire sign person is either a Sagittarius, Leo, or Aries individual. Usually Knight of Wands would be a Sagittarius. But it doesn't matter because the Knight of Wands is a little bit of a nasty card when it comes to love in a way, especially if you're looking for a one night stand or if you're looking for an open relationship or you're looking just for someone to have a bit of fun with, but you don't want anything serious, Aquarius, then that this is a great card to get because it means that this person will not be under duress to have a relationship with you, a long-term committed relationship. Because that's not what the Knight of Wands is about. Knight of Wands doesn't want a long-term relationship. Knight of Wands wants a hit-and-quit relationship. Knight of Wands wants to come and go. Knight of Wands wants to see you every other week or twice a week or once a week. That's what the Knight of Wands... Knight of Wands likes to depart but never arrive. In other words, the Knight of Wands doesn't like to stick around. All right, likes to depart, likes to come and go as he pleases, but doesn't like to arrive, male or female. So this is somebody who can be a bit of a commitment foe when he shows up in readings. You get this with the Two of Cups and you're fucked because it could mean a quick relationship or fleeting relationship or, you know, relationship with a Knight of Wands, which is going to, you know, very quick relationship, 3-month relationship, that type of thing. It looks like with this Eight of Wands that you are attracting in the Knight of Wands or many messages or many... lots of activity around love, lots of offers of love potentially, because these are the areas of love as well. So it might be there's lots of communication concerning a Knight of Wands and the King of Cups. Now, I know which guy I'd rather go for, and that would be the King of Cups. Because the King of Cups, even though he can be a little bit held back emotionally, he is also a king, which says that he's grown. He's a mature individual. This is the type of person who is looking for a soulmate. This is the type of person who is looking for somebody to reciprocate his feelings. Knight of Wands is only looking for someone to reciprocate his feelings as far as he wants it to go. So this is somebody who wants to play the field, okay? And he'll be looking for someone who wants that too, all right? The Knight of Wands might be looking for someone that will fall at his feet, but he doesn't want to fall at their feet. He wants everything kind of on his terms. Whereas the King of Cups for me is more of a card that says, I am a very kind of emotionally grounded, stable, secure individual. I'm also very self-aware in terms of emotion. So this, for me, the King of Cups is, I'm very unlikely to mess you about in terms of love. This is the person that will say, you know, if a relationship isn't working out, then let's sit down and talk about it and I'll tell you why I don't want this relationship. Whereas the Knight of Wands is more likely, ring, ring, hi, you there? Hello, is Matt there? Bang. Or, hi, this is Matt. Yep, not in right now. Leave a message. 2 weeks later, this is Matt, not in right now. He's the type of person that will put you on voicemail, man. This is the type of person that Knight of Wands is, because he's a commitment phobe, so he can do anything. He's wild, is the Knight of Wands. Free, wild. Goes with his passions. He will burn out very, very quickly in terms of love. He'll be all over you one moment, but then the next minute, nothing. Whereas the King of Cups for me is somebody who's more than likely going to stay in for the long haul. So I know which one. I feel that there's going to be a lot of activity love-wise around the Knight of Wands and a King of Cups. Where is this heading? And this is why I feel that the overall outcome is you guys are going to be having a lot of fun with that Four of Wands energy in terms of love. And where is it heading for you in terms of love? Oh, I already had it turned up. Temperance card. I feel that this is you guys here, and it's funny that the Temperance card should be this is Sagittarius and that's Sagittarius. So it could either mean that this person is playing you, because if you are falling for the Knight of Wands more than you're falling for the King of Cups, everybody, you know, a lot of people like a bad person, don't they? You know, especially females, they like a bad guy. Sometimes they don't see the treasures in somebody who is stable and emotionally available, which is the King of Cups a lot of the time. Might not show his feelings, but he's emotionally available. The Knight of Wands is not emotionally available. And it's funny that because the Knight of Wands is a Sagittarius and so is the Temperance card. So it could be a Sagittarius that some of you guys might be falling for. And if you're falling, I feel, for a Sagittarian in 2017, Aquarius, I feel you need to be on your guard, because this person with the Temperance card will possibly not be playing you, but they might be playing somebody else. This Temperance card holds two, this angel holds two cups, and he's weighing up, he or she is weighing up, or they're trying to create an even keel between the water in the two cups. So they're kind of, this person could be toying with your emotions. That's another word that comes to mind with this card, toying with emotions, because water are emotions. And you got the Two of Cups there. So this person could be toying with your emotions, for example, especially if it's this bad boy that you fall for here. Or this person might be toying not just with you, but they might be toying with somebody else and trying to kind of even out the time that they spend with you. So it could be that they have somebody else there potentially and not just you. If this is you Aquarius, then this will be you toying with two people potentially, I feel, with this Temperance card. Temperance means all sorts of things. It means, you know, patience. It means making adjustments, but it also means alternative. So potentially the overall outcome could be an alternative, maybe relationship here, which, you know, play on words, where you don't just, you know, stay monogamous to one person. It could be that you, you know, you toy with two people in 2017 in terms of relationship, but you're definitely having some fun here, I feel, in 2017. And let's have a look at what's going on in your future cards, or running theme through the year. So the Three of Wands is the overall energy, and usually when you get this card, it could be that you're waiting for something to come to you. You've put effort into an area within your life and now you're waiting for the results. Or it could be that you're looking to the future and you're waiting for your ships to come in, or you're waiting, you're expecting something really good to come to you with this card. What's underneath this? Two of Swords, Nine of Swords, and the Queen of Cups. I feel for some of you guys, it could be with the Three of Wands that the energy is that you might be waiting for something, or sometimes this card can mean your ships are coming in, or something's coming in quicker than you know. And it might be, for some of you guys, sometimes this card is where we are waiting and waiting, or we're looking out for something, but we're not sure what that is, or even if that's going to come or arrive for us. And some of you guys are in two minds over something. Seems to be leading to worry with that Nine of Cups, and maybe with this Queen of Pentacles, this is somebody that's helping you. Queen of Pentacles, sorry, can be an earth sign person. Usually she's seen as a Capricorn energy, but for the purpose of the reading, earth sign, male, female, Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn individual. But also the Queen of Pentacles is somebody who can give some really good advice. Okay, they're very kind, they're very nurturing, they're very helpful, they're very down to earth, so they know how to give you some very, very good advice. And it could simply be that you're waiting for a package to arrive. It sounds crazy, but you know, it could be that next year you find yourself in a position where you've been waiting for something to arrive for ages. And it might be this Two of Swords that you haven't heard anything, because sometimes this is a lack of communication. This might be something that you're worrying over, and maybe something gives you somebody gives you some reassurance here with the Queen of Pentacles. Maybe you're on the phone to someone, you say, you know what, I ordered this package from so and such and such a place, and it's been 2 weeks overdue. It hasn't arrived, and I'm really worried because I've had no communication about it, and I'm worried about it. And somebody's on the phone, and they say, you know what, look, don't worry about it, I'll sort it out for you. Because this is a helpful card when you get this, okay? And the fact that she's offering something that's practical, some sort of down-to-earth advice or something with that pentacle towards you. And this is you, Aquarius, because you're swords, okay? So Two of Swords is you, Nine of Swords is you. So it might be that you're at an impasse as well over a situation here, and you're worried about it, and you get some advice from the Queen of Pentacles. Could also be that you're at an impasse here, and it could be with that Three of Swords. Usually the Two of Swords means when you're in impasse, you don't really know, you know, what direction to take. You're kind of at a crossroads with this Two of Swords here. You're in two minds. And it could be because the overall energy is, you know, when I'm looking out for something, but I'm not sure whether it's going to arrive, or, you know, what it is that I'm actually looking for. And therefore, I might be worried about it. Could be around your security or finances or something. I don't see much financial problems here as such. I don't feel that you have huge, huge financial problems in 2017. Everything looks pretty good, to be perfectly honest with you, Sagittarius. But I do feel it could be that maybe you're in two minds. With that Nine of Swords, it's worrying you. And it could be around something to do with your finances, or even in, you know, making sure that you stay financially solvent, stable, secure, all the rest of it. And it could easily line up, I guess, with this area here in terms of work, that you are waiting for something here, but it shows that there's great joy, possibly over a promotion that brings great happiness, or great joy over a promotion enables you to leave a particular job, because the Ten of Cups can also be leaving, or successful collaboration in an agreement, or successful outcome over agreement leads to the greatest happiness with the Ten of Cups, okay? So for some of you guys, it might be that you are waiting for something here. You're holding out with the Nine of Wands. You've got an idea and you're sticking firm to it, but it says that things are going to turn okay, especially if there's anything to do with working within a team-centric situation here. And here it would really kind of tally up, especially if the waiting is in connection with these cards here. because it's something around your financial security. But it sees you that you're okay here. For some of you guys, it might be something to do with mental health in 2017, I'm feeling, because the swords represent the mental. And I feel that this Two of Swords could be something to do with that. Maybe some of you guys are blocking something out and it's causing some worry. So there might be some form of suppressing feelings with this Two of Swords energy. You're blocking them out mentally or blocking certain things out, and it's worrying you. And it might be that the Queen of Pentacles is a nurse that can offer help in this area. She offers practical ways and methods in order to unlock certain things that you might have been suppressing for quite a while, that might have been kind of weighing down on you, Aquarius, mentally, right from way back, way before 2017. So there might be something here in terms of dealing with mental health issues, I feel, with these cards in the future running theme area for some of you guys. And it can also be, I feel, that maybe you're worrying that somebody has blocked you out, or you haven't spoken to somebody in a while. The Two of Swords can mean block out, haven't spoken to somebody in a while. It might be worrying you because of the Queen of Pentacles. So it might be that this person is usually really kind and they're open and they're nurturing. Maybe you haven't heard from someone in a while, a friend like this Queen of Pentacles. Maybe that worries you, that type of thing. But let's have a look at the overall outcome for the future area. Well, the World card, and the World card means achievement. So you're definitely making some form of accomplishment or achievement in this area here. Also, the World card speaks of completion of a situation. So I feel that there is completion here. A lot of learning as well, especially if you're going through any type of mental health issues here. I feel that this person will help you find a way, even though we've not seen the Queen of Swords, like a psychologist or psychiatrist. We're definitely seeing someone who's able to offer practical methods of how you overcome a certain area within your life that's causing you some mental distress. And I feel the World card might say that you complete a certain course of action, or you complete on a certain program maybe that some of you guys are going through in 2017 to help you get better, that type of thing. But there's some huge accomplishments and achievements made here in this area, especially if this is linked to this area here with the work situation here. And we do see here in your personal life that there is an offer made to somebody who's quite independent, perhaps something that you're going to need to weigh up with that Two of Pentacles. Could be that you're weighing up the children, that type of thing. Maybe you're in two minds because, and it makes you worried because you are the Queen of Pentacles. Queen of Pentacles can be a mother. Queen of Pentacles can be somebody who, again, a single mother, that type of thing, who is looking after the home, the family. So it could be something to do with having to wait, you know, deal with work situations and also children, that type of thing. And it just says that I feel that, you know, you'll get through this with the World card, because you will complete on this stage. And even though you've got a lot of things that you need to get through in 2017, you'll get there. Let's have a look where your wishes are. What are you wishing for? Well, you're wishing for the Chariot, and that's brilliant, because the Chariot says, and you've got it here as well, even though it looks slightly different, we can actually see the horses being, you know, dragging this Chariot here. But he's kind of whacking them, and he's kind of saying, you know, yeah, yeah, you know, yeah, yeah. He's bringing them into alignment. And this is what I feel, what your wishes are with the Chariot is to overcome obstacles, but not just that, but it's also to bring your world and your life into some form of alignment where you, you know, really one of the key words for the Chariot is control. So I feel that you're looking to bring control back to your world here. Figures out for me in the future area. It figures out for me in the career area. It figures out for me in the personal situation. I'm not so sure about the love situation here. It might be that you are trying to, you're wishing to, that you can, this can be that your hopes and desires are to maybe have control over a couple of people here, okay, that you can kind of, you know, bring into tandem two forces, two people within your life, King of Wands, King of Cups, Knight of Wands, without any type of negative fallback, manage two relationships. This person is, after all, managing two things, two horses. He's juggling, he's managing two things quite satisfactory here. He's able to keep them kind of on the straight and narrow. So it might be that your wish and hopes and desires are to kind of juggle two relationships or something like that, maybe for some of you guys. But most of all, this is about control. So I feel that your wishes, your hopes and desires are to bring control into your world in the year 2017. Let's have a look at the overall outcome for the year. Well, that's great. It's the Wheel of Fortune, and the Wheel of Fortune says, you know, there's great things that are happening for you. There might be overall outcome, might be some things are unexpected, but I feel the way that the year is heading with the Wheel of Fortune, the Wheel of Fortune is an excellent card when it speaks about, you know, positive changes for the better happening. fortunate situations, synchronicities, things coming in out of the blue that perhaps you didn't expect happening. But more than anything, with this overall outcome card of the Wheel of Fortune, for me, it's really saying that, you know, things are on the up for Aquarius in 2017. You've got a beautiful, beautiful reading, you know, possible relationships in your home life section. Could be moving to another country, potentially, for some of you guys. Could be potentially pregnancy. We do have a page of wands, the sun. We do, you know, possibly really kind of taking responsibility for home situations here. Possibly home renovations, things like that coming in for you guys. You're really looking to kind of bring your home into some form of balance here. And it's saying with the Wheel of Fortune, things are looking good in the home area. But also this card can be the overall outcome. Things are a little bit 50-50. It's down to the fates, especially if this is a relationship and you need to kind of discover a bit more with that moon card here showing up. I feel that the Wheel of Fortune, in terms of this area, in terms of your love area, again, 50-50, there are two people here. Okay, if you, there has been a love drought for you, it could be with the overall outcome that things are actually changing in your favour. You know the saying, you look for a bus and one doesn't come along and then you forget about it and 100 come along at once. So it could be mean that if you've not had love for a while, that suddenly loads of people start coming in for you with this card here as well. And if you're going through any mental health problems or anything like that in 2017 or a little bit of a loss of direction, it's how things are changing for the better with that Wheel of Fortune. Let's have a look at the overall advice card. Wow, the Two of Cups, brilliant. So overall advice, I feel the Two of Cups is that you should have successful negotiations as seen in the career section here. There should be successful friendships and partnerships potentially seen in the future area here. Two of Cups can mean new relationships, love relationships, potentially being seen within the love area here and also the home area here. I feel that the partnership card could be that somebody is offering you something in the personal situation as well that could correlate to the working situation, especially if it's a promotion or something, because it looks like a successful agreement with that Two of Cups. And also here, in the personal situation. So this is probably one of the best readings that I've done for the year ahead. I feel if not the best, it is the best one, the Aquarius one, because the cards are so bright, so happy, so lovely, and it just, everything just looks great for the year for you. Really, really good. Yeah, there's things that you still need to kind of find out about. You need a bit more clarity on. Don't go jumping in so quick. You know, you meet someone within the first 2 weeks and you say, woohoo, we're getting married. It possibly could be marriages, but with the Two of Cups, but not really. I feel that, you know, some of you guys might already be married anyway, but I feel with this Two of Cups, it speaks of pledges, friendships, alliances, agreements, negotiations. The Two of Cups is one of those cards where two people are on the same page. It's not always love, no, but it's, you know, it talks about successful partnerships and successful unions, and there are successful unions, possibly, you know, a re-establishment of friendships here as well within the future area, because something's achieved with that World card. Okay, understandings are achieved here, especially if there are broken friendships. So it speaks of, you know, successful partnerships coming in, negotiations, pledges, friendships, conversations, meetings, that type of thing. It's a very, very good year in terms of this reading for Aquarius. And I wish you guys all the best for 2017. And I will see you on your year ahead, not year ahead, your monthly reading, January monthly reading, real soon. Take care.